Yeah, it's brilliant, obviously, especially with the high standard of the team. Like, even Katie, like, as obviously females, it's to look up to them and see what they're doing. Like, it's great. And Ronan, Chris, all the lads, like, as well, there's such a variety of categories going. It's not just solo bikes, it's solo bikes and tandems. So, to be included, obviously, for any world championships is brilliant. So, yeah, I'm really looking forward to it.
This is your third World Championships overall. It'll be your second track World Championships. All happened in a reasonably short space of time. So, how much have you changed as an athlete, and what have you learned since your first World Championships?
Yeah,
What is
basically,
it?
like, so last year, less than a year ago, I was called on squad, so it's not even been a full year yet. So from there, I went to my first World Championships in Apeldoorn last year. So I was going there just for the experience, really, like, to see what it was about. You know, I was obviously going to try my best, but I had limited experience and limited amount of training. So then I had the Road World Championships in Emmen in September. So that was when I think, like, you could see the progression from one to the other. I obviously improved a lot, and I believe I'm, like, even stronger again now with the more training. Again, like with cycling, you need the base, so you need all the hours you can get, and you're building your base gradually. Even though for people track just seems like such a short, like, the distance is like 3 kilometer pursuit, 500 meters is short, but you still need the endurance there to basically make yourself go faster.
And are they totally different skills that you need between the track and the road?
Yeah, like, the track is completely different. Like, for people who don't know, the track, it's like indoor and the events are short, but you still need the road base, so you're doing road miles just to keep your endurance. Like, you can't just focus on track and forget about endurance, because then you're basically back to square one. Like, so the track, it's more intense. So when we're on track training camps or that, you're training, like, every time you get onto the track to do an effort, it's flat out. There's no, like, literally just cruising around zone two. Like, you might on the road, you might do 3 or 4 hours just easy, whereas on the track it's flat out. Every time you get on the track, you're flat out. So
And you're constantly looking at your competition, so
yeah,
they're driving you on, and do you find that that's more difficult?
like, a lot, some of the girls in my category obviously have massive experience. They've been to Paralympic Games, some of them have been to two. Like, so I did last year, like, I tried to take in as much as I can. Even now, like, I need to use the experience to learn, so, like, watch what they're doing, just simple things like that. Like, you need to keep an eye on what they're doing. Obviously, for me, being new to the sport, it is like literally looking at what they're doing, but also, like, focusing on what I'm doing. So I'm going as hard as I can, I'm giving it my best, but you need to see what they're doing as well to see where you are in regards to, like, world rankings and all that. Like, so
You're not a novice in sport, although you're a short time in cycling, relatively speaking. You have a sport background in Gaelic football, but what is the difference in terms of the effort, the skill, the training that you have to do compared between Gaelic football and cycling?
yeah, I just think cycling is such a hard sport. Like, it's so much harder than, like, football was obviously hard. You go out and you train, you're 3 times a week, 4 times a week, running around the pitch and that. But cycling is just so hard. Like, it just takes hours and preparation. So, like, your food, you need to eat a certain amount of time beforehand. You know what you're going to do. The intensity is so high, and I think it gave me that good feeling of being back playing sport. Like, the pain you feel, the good pain. Like, so you're training hard and it's hurting, but it's hurting for the right reasons. Like, when I look back at football now, I think, like, I gave my all in football, but, like, it's nothing in comparison to cycling. Like, cycling is just, it's one of the toughest sports. Like, you're flat out, you're putting in the hours and all that. So yeah, I'd consider it, like, much more difficult than football. Like, obviously it's different and it's not really a team sport. Like, we are as a team, but you're out for 10 hours a week more on your own on the bike. Like, you're on your own training, you're on your own in the gym. Like, it's a lot less like a team sport. When I got into it first, I thought, you know, I like team sports. I like being around, always, like, never stop talking, all that. But I think cycling is different, and it is, you need to get used to your own company, like, because you have to train by yourself. There's no point training with other people because different standards. You know, you might need to do a specific training session, and the person you're out training with isn't doing the same thing. So it's a lot of what you do with your time. So
Then, when you're in such an individual sport now, after that team sport experience, does it make the highs higher? You've recently had a good result in Manchester, so when you clinched that medal, did you feel higher than you maybe would have as a team sport, or how does it compare?
yeah, I think it's different. Like, obviously as a team sport, like, I was a goalie, so if I let in a goal, like it's kind of affecting the whole team. Or you might save something, or you might play brilliant, but it doesn't necessarily mean you win. Whereas in cycling, if you give your all, and if you do well, and if you win a medal, like it's because you put in the work. Like, yeah, you're like your coaches and everyone behind the scenes obviously have helped massively, but again, like they can't get on the track or they can't race, you have to do that. Like, so yeah, it is, it's for yourself, like, but it's also for like your family and people that have supported you, like, but it is different. Like, you're winning as a team and everything's a team and everyone's great, so it's, yeah, it is definitely the individual win, and it feels good, like, yeah.
And those individual wins, you have opportunities when you're in Canada, you're competing in four events.
Yep.
Can you just take us through what those events are and what's involved?
So basically the first one will be on the Thursday. That's the 3 kilometer individual pursuit. So for people who don't know, the way that works is you start, one person starts on either side of the track and it's a timed event. So you're timed over the 3K. And then out of that, the four top times go into like the gold medal write-off and the bronze medal write-off. So you're going, if you, whoever qualifies the fastest will go into the gold and silver and then next bronze and that. So basically what you need to do is your, for your qualification, you need to go as fast as you can. There's no, some people think, oh, you should wait until the gold medal write-off to give it your all, like, but really you have to get there by going as fast as you can. So that's the 3 kilometer pursuit, so that's timed again. So there, in my category, there are different ranges of, like, I suppose athletes at different stages of their training and that. So some girls will be extremely fast and then there'll be, you know, one's a bit slower and then the ones who are only starting off. So it is about literally you're timed, so it's about how fast you go over the 3K, and it's as simple as that. Like, so for people that watch it, like, you'd see it on the TV where they cross the line the same time or whatever, but in my category anyway, there'd be girls that might be going faster, so you might get caught, you're caught by half a lap or that, but it is your own timed. So whether someone on the track with you or not, it doesn't make a difference.
And is there, of those events, is there any of them that you particularly prefer?
Well, I thought, last year, I thought I preferred the 500 metres. Not because it's short, even though some people think it will be. But I thought I'd be good over, like, I'd like to see myself as a bit of a sprinter, but unfortunately that's not really the case. But no, I like the scratch because it's a bunch race. Like, the scratch race is basically everyone's on the track at the same time. It's not time, but it's just who crossed the line first. So it's a race, like, you know, when you're timed against yourself, yeah, you're going as hard as you can, but I just like to have an idea of what's going on around me, where people are, that sort of stuff. So yeah, I'd say I like the scratch.
It appeals to your competitive nature a bit.
Yeah,
more.
I think so, yeah.
Very good. You, you've had some issues with your bike recently. Your transport let you down. How is the bike?
Yeah, it's all right, yeah. It's just, it's a lot, I think it's a lot harder, like in other sports you might have to bring as much equipment with, but with cycling, like, you need wheels and bikes and everything, and flying with them can be a bit tricky sometimes, you know. Bike or baggage handlers are a bit, you know, they see a box and it's just kind of thrown in that, so you just have to make sure it's well padded and hope that when you open it, it's all in one piece. And it's,
tell us about the bike. What it's a specialist piece of kit, I assume, so, you know, is it valuable?
Yeah, basically, like, they can be as expensive as you want them to be, basically. But for para athletes and for me in particular, like, my bike is specially made for me because of my disability and because of the weakness on my right side. Everything, like gears, brakes, levers, all that are on my left-hand side. So it's not just as simple as if something happens, I can get a replacement bike. Like, I need to get it made specifically for me. So yeah, it costs a lot of money, and it's cycling as well. People are like, oh, you have a bike, it's grand. Like, even my dad, like, or my parents, when I said I need another bike, they're like, you have a bike, like. But I was like, yeah, but that's for road racing, you need one for TT as well, so that's different again. And then you need one for the track, so that's different again. So I think telling them I needed 3 different bikes was a bit of a shock. But again, the girls you're competing against have the best bikes there is, and that's, I think, another level up. So when you get better at the sport and you're going as fast as you can, then the equipment makes a massive difference. So the better equipment you have, the faster you're going to go. But I think for me personally, because I'm new, I'm just trying to get as strong as I can, like, get my legs to go as fast as I can, get as aero as I can, and then the equipment will obviously help you go faster then. And you can always keep upgrading your equipment, but you can't really upgrade yourself. You're as fast as you can go, or you're training as hard as you can, and your equipment then will obviously add to that, as opposed to, like, some people think, oh, I have the best bike, I have the best skin suit, I have the best helmet, I'm going to go the fastest. It's still about you pushing the bike. So
doing things like going to training camps is useful, and you've had a couple to help you reach those higher standards. What have those camps been like? Which is again a reasonably new experience for someone like yourself.
Yeah, like I used to play soccer. I played soccer underage for Ireland, and that, so we would have gone away in that, but cycling's completely different. Like, I find the camps very beneficial for me. As someone with a brain injury, like, fatigue is a massive element. So we'll say I'm at home and I have training and then I have three other things to do in the day, like, it can affect obviously my tiredness levels, my fatigue levels. Whereas when you're on the camp, you're there to train. So you get up, you eat, you go train, you come back, like, you'd be able to sleep in the middle of the day and then you'd be able to train again, like. But you're completely focused on your training. You're not thinking about the 20 other things that have to be done at home. So I just find that, for me personally, I find the camps brilliant, like. And I'm not really a home bird, as in, obviously I like being at home, but I wouldn't get homesick, like. So I think when I was thrown into it last year, I basically rang a week before the camp and been like, you're going on a training camp next week for 5 weeks, like. And I wasn't like, oh my god, going for 5 weeks. I was like, grand, like, training for 5 weeks, sure, a camp will make you better, like. So yeah, I really think the camps do benefit me, and having that structure as well. So with the fatigue wise, for me personally, I'd have to, you know, watch how tired I am and all that. So like, we'll say I had a hair training, it might be 3 hours, I'd have to go like sleep. Just like, that's the way my brain would like repair itself, like. So with a brain injury, fatigue is a problem. So if I get really fatigued, like, my speech and that sort of stuff, my walk get a lot worse. But I think with learning about cycling and with like getting to know my body as it is now, I feel like I'm much better. Like, I go for the sleep in the middle of the day, I rest when I need to, I take days off if I need to, like. Because if you don't, it's not just going to affect that day, it'll probably affect the week. So I think getting to know that as well was interesting, and seeing other people, like in parasport, you see people who have different disabilities, so seeing what they do as well made a massive difference. And being on camp, obviously seeing other athletes like Ronan, who's also on a solo bike, Chris, he's on a solo bike, and then the tandems, like what they do, I like to kind of, like, they're obviously the best in their category, they're the best in Ireland. So if they're doing something, you want to do as well, because if it's making them better, it'll more than likely make you better as well.
That camp, you obviously learned a lot on your camps, because you came back and competed in Manchester. You took 17 seconds off your PB.
Yeah.
Like, the benefits have obviously already been shown.
Yeah, like, that was massive. As in, for Ireland, they don't have velodrome, so if we need to go train on the track, we have to go abroad on that. So I hadn't been on the track in a good while, but literally, just from the base training, getting there and giving it your all, like, 17 seconds is massive over 12 laps. So I just hope that you can keep improving on that. Obviously, when you start cycling first, you make massive improvements because, you know, you're training, you're cutting off time. But when you get to a high standard, it's impossible to even take a second off. So I just hope that I can, like, keep cutting them seconds as much as I can, like, to get me higher up in the rankings and higher up in my class, basically.
And then getting up high in the rankings, there's an ultimate aim there, I assume, which is Tokyo. So tell us about your hopes for this year.
Yeah, basically, like, the main thing is obviously to qualify for Tokyo, and to go there, like, to compete, not just to take part. Like, when I started cycling, I was obviously focused on Paris, you know, because you don't just qualify, like, it's not the way it works, you know. You need to get your qualification points, you need to be at a certain standard. Like, Cycling Ireland, Paralympics Ireland, they're not just going to send you because there's a slot there, you know. You need to be good enough to compete. So I think going to the World Championships in Canada now, I need to show where I am and how much I've progressed, and showing that I'm willing to give everything for it, because basically Tokyo is my aim for the year. And, like, to get there, I have to be as good, if not better, than some of the girls in my category, and that's what I hope to show in Canada.
You have a lot of support behind you from the likes of Cycling Ireland. You have gone to those training camps, you've competed well, but there's the other side as well. You seem to have a lot of support behind you between family. I see you were named the sports person of the month in the Roscommon Herald.
Yeah.
That must be a nice feeling, knowing that you've got so many people supporting you.
Yeah, like, it's brilliant. Obviously, Cycling Ireland have been a massive help with camps, training, Neil coaching. Like, it does make a difference. You can't do any of this on your own, so you need that backing. And I think having, like, a coach that everything's now done through, like, apps on your phone, and you're in constant contact. So there's no saying, like, you know, we might have had to run for football, do a 5K run, and so you just say, yeah, I did it. You might not necessarily done it. So for this, it's everything is recorded, and everything's so advanced now, like, technology wise, you know where you stand, it's no lying about it, like. So Cycling Ireland obviously have been a massive help. The training camps clearly benefit me hugely, like, and without their support we wouldn't be going to it, so we wouldn't have velodrome time, we wouldn't have any of that. So obviously I'm very grateful for that. And then at home, like my family have been massively supportive. I remember like being like to my parents, obviously like I need to do sport. Like when I had the brain injury, they're like, okay, listen, try it for a year. So last year basically got into cycling and I was kind of like iffy about will I do it, will I, you know, I wasn't going to be able to work full time anyways. So I was working part time and they were like, listen, you can work for the rest of your life. You mightn't get this opportunity again. Like, so basically they've put a lot into it and I could say funded me, I suppose. So it's made a massive difference. It's good to know that people like support you. Obviously they've always, we've been a sporty family. So there's always been like following matches, following everything. So I think now they're even trying to like understand and cycle more. Cause at the start, like even the thoughts of needing two different bikes, just like, they were like, what? Like, you know, it need, you need, cycling's complicated. Like you need to learn as much about it. So I think now they're, yeah, they're pretty happy that I'm doing it, I suppose.